Hello, my name is Akul Marwa. I'm also in class 10. And I would say my favorite cartoon character would be Roadrunner.
Roadrunner?
Yeah,
BB. He does that well. And your teammate is?
Motu
or Patli.
Fantastic! Lovely cartoon. I remember when I was about that small, I was greeted in this lovely magazine called Loadport. I don't know if Loadport is still around, but Motu Patlu have graduated to television. So I see them every other day because my kids watch the thing now, and it's amazing to see something that you grew up on being watched by your kids as well. Fantastic. Welcome on board, Motu Patlu. And the next team is from Shiv Nadar School, Gurgaon, and they will introduce themselves.
I am Sai from class 10, Shiv Nadar School, and my favorite cartoon character is Iron Man.
I am Soham Kumar from grade 7 only, and my favorite cartoon character is Deadpool.
Is?
Deadpool.
Deadpool. Fantastic. And your team name is?
Team B.
Team D.
B.
B. Team B. Would you like me to give you a name? No, you're the Powerpuff Girl. You asked. You said I can give you a name. You have to think up of a nice fucking name for yourself. Otherwise, I'm serious. You will be called Powerpuff Girl from here on. See, you have helpful neighbors. They're saying they can call themselves Dumb and Dumber. No, no, not in the end. I have to call you through the quiz. I'm not going to say Shiv Nadar School sitting at position B. So you have all of 5 seconds to think up of a name.
Lauren and Hardy.
3, 2, 1 second to go before you are labeled Powerpuff Girls forever.
Team name.
Yeah, team name. Sorry, Shikshantar.
Our team name is Livermorium. It's the 150th element in the periodic table.
Livermorium. Name for Lawrence Livermore. The next team is the Air Force School, Subroto Park.
Morning people, I'm Herman. I'm in class 10.
I'm Dhanmay, class 10.
And now both of you have to identify your favorite film stars.
Actually, I don't really watch movies.
You don't really watch movies, or you don't watch movies at all?
But I like Angelina Jolie.
Angelina Jolie, yes! Woo! I'm so glad.
I like Eminem. In the movie,
like Eminem.
Yes. Yeah.
It's only one thing.
I
that left a bit of impression on your mind.
Yeah.
Fantastic. And your team name?
We're the Foxbacks.
They're the Foxbacks. I suppose they should be the fastest ever interceptor to fly in the skies, the MiG-25. And coming up to the last team on our stage, I am Faltume, A-Y-F-M for short.
I'm Saksham Singh from class 10. I'm Karthike Bansal from class 10.
And who's your favorite author?
It should be Enid Blyton.
And?
Robert Hood actually. He writes astronomical books.
Oh wow. Fantastic. So, a very, very somber and serious note on which to end the introduction. Just after Angelina Jolie. It's perfect sense. And just in case you guys were wondering why they're all here, this is the stuff they're competing for. The winner, that's them here, each of them gets a cash prize of 10,000 rupees, plus each of them gets books worth 15,000 rupees. Right, so the first prize is worth 50 with 3 zeros after that. The runners up get cash prizes of 5,000 rupees each and books worth an additional 10,000. So, huge amounts. We haven't forgotten the third position team. Like we did in the schools, the winners and the runners up both got cash prizes plus books. The team in third place, we didn't forget them. We gave them a set of books as well, and they get a huge number of books. They're mentioned here on this gift check. There's 4 books each. The value is about 5 grand per package. Okay? And don't take me to court on this, but it's about 5 grand. Apart from that, we've got like 25-30 prizes for the audience. So lots of questions coming your way. In fact, the first question coming your way. Going to, yes. First hand going up, Sriram School, fantastic. You're going to help us explain the first round to the teams. Okay, both of you, as a team. You came here as a team, you'll take part as a team. And if you get the answer, you win a prize as a team. Okay, can we have question number one for the audience for round one of the progressive clues? Here it comes. You have to identify this character. Okay? First clue is an audio clue. So I want all the teams to understand this. First clue will always be an audio clue. Play the audio clue, please.
In summer or fall, all you've got to do is call, and I'll be there, yeah. You've got a friend.
Okay, so that's the audio clue. Do you have an answer for me? No? Hold on. Let's take the hand off first. Biscuits? They call chai and duba biscuit. Let's see. It's a beautiful name, and I'm really sorry to not be saying it every round on the stage, but I think you guys lost out by a point and a half. Okay, and the teams that missed out, the honorable mentions, one went out by half point, I'm not too sure which one it was, the other went out by just a quarter point, just one fourth of a point. So, okay, second clue. If you can't get it off the first clue, if you get it off the first clue, you get 60 points. Right? If you want the second clue, here it is. It's a text clue. We tell you something. Dash lives in a swamp in a kingdom called Duloc, ruled by Lord Farquaad. He prefers his solitude and hates it when fairy tale characters invade his swamp. Shrek it is. Come on up and we'll give you a prize. And in case, get the number one for each of them. Just in case you didn't get it off the text clue, there's a third clue. Can we have clue number three, which is a visual clue? Team A. Ami Public School. We will start your quiz now. Your question is coming up. The first clue, as I told you, is an audio. Identify this personality, listen to the voice, and then tell me if you want to take your guess. If you... Anthony Hopkins is incorrect. I want yes.
Woody Allen
it is. Can we have a prize for the young man that's hand up? Please clap for him. Okay. So I'm afraid no points there, Army Public School. Next one coming up for you. Super Quizzers. Your audio clue coming up. Listen carefully.
Ancient order of monks in the world. I thank you in the name of the mother of religions. And I thank you in the name of the millions and millions of Hindu people of all classes and faiths. My thanks also to some of the speakers on this platform who, referring to the delegates from your event, have told you that these men...
Okay, that is your audio clue. Do you want to try on this for 60 points or... would you like to the second clue for 40? Remember, you gave a wrong answer, it's zero. Second clue for 40 points. He's regarded as a patriotic spiritual leader and his birthday is celebrated as National Youth Day in India. Would you like the third clue for 20 points? Or are you trying for this? Trying? Remember, 40 or 0. Go ahead. Use the mic. 3, 2. You have an answer? Would you want the third clue? You can go for the third clue at any time. Third clue, the visual. Can we have an image of the person, please?
Swami
Vivekananda. It is 20 points to Super Cuber. They open that account and they open the account of all the teams here on stage. So please give them a slightly bigger round of applause.
So that the first point being scored in the finale round here. Next one for you, Shankar Bihar. Take a careful listen to what this person is saying.
I would like to thank Yuri Milner for founding these prizes to recognize outstanding work that may not qualify for the Nobel Prize because it is very difficult or impossible to confirm experimentally.
Okay, do you want the giving the answer for 60 or would you like the next clue for 40 points? Remember, if you get it wrong, it's zero. The next clue, taking you down to 40 points, he was the Lucasian Professor of Mathematics at the University of Cambridge from 1979 to 2009. Stephen Hawking gets you full 40 points, well done. 40 points to Team C there, and the next one coming up for you, Shankar. You have to identify this personality, listen to the audio clue, and then we'll have it for you.
I'll state my case, of which I'm certain. I have lived a life that's full. I travel each and every highway and more, much more than this.
Okay, you heard the voice. Do you want to take a guess on this or do you want the next clue for 40 points? Next clue for 40 points. Peter Lawford, Sammy Davis Jr., Joey Bishop, Dean Martin, and this person were collectively known as the Rat Pack. Sammy Davis Jr., Joey Bishop, Dean Martin, Peter Lawford, and this person whose voice you heard. Third clue for 20 points now. That's it. And commonly called by a nickname because of the color of his eyes. Yep. Memorial. Still got a little time. Chakra, oh, blue eyes as he was called. And the next clue for you, Foxbats, coming your way. Listen carefully for your audio clue.
Had to go fishing on the sideline. He had to grow strawberries and capsicums to actually support his passion, which was his wildlife facility.
Yeah. You grew up with the animals, haven't you? Yeah.
Okay. Very, very distinctive accent and voice.
The next clue, please.
The next clue for 40 points now. His wife, Terry, worked with him on his very unconventional but very popular nature documentary on TV. At any stage, you can take a guess.
Can I give the name of the documentary?
The name of the documentary? No. I mean, you can, but it won't get you points. I want the name of the personality.
It's Man, Woman, Wild, but...
Man, Woman, Wild?
I think it's that.
The next I don't know what kind of TV shows you'll be watching. The next clue for 20 points is picture.
Steve.
Steve Jobs. Steve Tyler. Steve Smith.
Steve.
Steve Irwin.
Steve Irwin, it is right on 20 points to them.
Well done, Bob Jack. Thank you.
Yeah. A little bit of leeway because A, he's so entertaining to watch, and B, he had it. Okay, the last question of this round coming up for you. I am a Paltu man. Time to prove your own name wrong.
I love the Lanka Lassi Surina. India is not in the Rama Ralaram. India is not in the Gulma Vanya and your Majesty Simiru Gorila. I'm doing the Tala Vali Tala Mali.
Okay. That was the voice. Who's the personality? You want the next clue?
Second clue.
Second clue. In the 1920s, he translated Beowulf. He began work on his most famous work in 1937 and finished it in 1949, of which over 150 million copies have been sold to date. You want the third clue? Third clue, the image of the personality, famous person, classic image. Lots of hands going up. Greedy boy who already won a prize. Yes. I am Paltu Bhai. Your time's up. You have an answer. Three. Passing. Okay, audience. Yes, someone who's almost falling out of his seat. Yes.
J.R.R. Tolkien
it is. And that was Tolkien reciting his own poem. Okay. What prize there? Excellent intelligentsia. First clue coming up for you. First video. Sorry, your excellent intelligentsia. Oh, I've got the order. Fantastic. You guys are Motu or Patlu?
My bad.
Okay. Can we have the stage lights down now? First clue coming up. Motu or Patlu? Take a look at the screen. We play your clip, ask you a question. You give the answer, you get 40 points, otherwise it passes for 20 bonus. Here it goes.
Oh my God.
There. So that is Forrest Whitaker playing the role of Idi Amin
the dictator of Uganda, and the film was called Last King of Scotland. Next question coming up for you. Super Quizzers. Take a look at the clip and we'll ask you your question.
Don't give me legs!
Okay. Two parts to this. Identify the Oscar winning actor and the film. This is one of the biggest names in the business, winning the first of his Oscar awards. And name the film. Who is the actor? Super Quizzes. From Shivnagar School, Gurgaon. You guys have an answer? Thinking? No? Take a guess. There's no negative. So, you don't lose anything. If you pass, you lose the chance to score points. Two parts. Either one correct gets you part one. You're passing it? Going across. Doing excellent intelligentsia. Passing to Livermorium. Fox bats passing to IMF Altume.
ISO ka 2 pe to ISO kitna rakhe aur 50
am 2.8 take a guess
to bahar ho
yaar try karke
agar jaise do bandon ko chhod dena 2.8
pass pass
to 100 apni
speed Steven Spielberg is the director and the film passing hai not correct But at least you tried for one of it.
2.5 है तो कोई दिक्कत नहीं है फिर तो flash की intensity.
Never give up.
ठीक है plus में 3.
Go to मत तो. Okay so we give it to you.
The Departed Martin
Scorsese. The Departed is correct. Martin Scorsese has his release of The Departed.
Actually मैं शूट कर रहा हूँ.
Okay. It's always a little easier. To answer questions when you're sitting there. The next question coming up for you, Livermorium. Take a look at the clip, then we'll ask you the question. Look carefully at the clip. Name the film
for half points and name the kind of chariot you saw. And the clue is, I gave you, it's got four horses pulling it. Each of those chariots. This is the forerunner of Formula One, so that was Lewis Hamilton, and who's currently the rival? One is Hamilton and Nico Rosberg. Gladiator and four horse chariot. What is it called? It is not called four horse chariot.
It's a gladiator chariot.
It's a gladiator chariot. No, pass it to Foxbat.
The film is Ben-Hur.
The film is Ben-Hur. You get 10 points on the pass and the name given to this kind of a chariot. Three, two, one.
It's the four horse chariot.
It was wrong then, but not enough then and not enough now. So, now 10 points on the pass, available. What do you want? I'll give it to you, 10 points. I have Pantume. It's a quadriga. Quadriga. I'll give it to you. Simple. The Latin word for quad. Quad. Quadrangle, quadrant, quadriga. Fantastic. You had a biga, you had a triga, and you had a quadriga. Fantastic. 10 points to Team F. I have Altume, and 10 points to Foxbats for getting Ben-Hur. That is the 1959, I think it was, film with Charlton Heston as Judah Ben-Hur. And Steve Boyd as Messala, the guy in black, the fancy helmet, KKR Borano. Next one coming up for you, Foxbat. Click first, then the question.
No,
today is the 4th of July. And
you will once again be fighting for our freedom. Not from tyranny, oppression, or persecution, but from annihilation.
Okay, now that movie, of course, the very famous one, it's called Independence Day. Obviously, that's not going to be the question. Two parts, name the actor and the defense establishment in which the speech is being given.
The defense establishment is NORAD.
NORAD, okay.
No, sorry, it's Area 52. It's Area 52.
Okay, and? You can describe the actor, you can see the actor. No, pass it.
The defense establishment is right, do we give the answer to that? Or
you give both.
Area 51 and we don't know the actor.
Area 51, not NORAD, not Area 52, it's Area 51. And specifically it's Edwards Air Force Base, which comes inside Area 51. So 10 points on the pass. And now for the actor. Super quizzer. 3, 2, 1. Intelligentsia, pass it to Livermorium. There's no point looking now. You see the film, you know the film. I'm not going to ask you Will Smith. Right? Coming round, pass it. Fox Bats.
No, places Edwards Air Force Base, of course.
Yes.
Actor is John Smith.
Passing over. Someone in the audience. Yes, at the back.
Bill Pullman.
Bill Pullman. Yes, the young lady gets a prize. That's Bill Pullman. We have a quick question for the audience. Audience, please play the clip.
Sons of Scotland! I am William Wallace. William Wallace is 7 feet tall.
Yes,
I'm hard. Killed men by the hundred. I'm a viewer here.
Okay, you can put your hands up, I will ask.
Yes, I...
Someone who hasn't answered yet. Yes, young man. No.
Okay.
The name, the question is, name the director of this film. And the second part. What can we ask? Okay. Film though, I think everyone can name. No, everyone can't name. Okay, so let's name the film and the director. Is absolutely correct. Braveheart and Mel Gibson. BTS, Noida, right?
Yeah.
Fantastic. That brings us to the end of two rounds. We'll take a look at the scores as they stand after two rounds. Before going into our third round, which is a set of directorial questions, we take 6 questions this way, then we reverse and go back. Let's have the scores. APS Noida 10 points, Shiv Nadar 20, Shankar Vihar 40, Shiv Shankar Mahir of the Mark, Air Force School 30, and APS Noida 10.